Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to go over the life cycle of ferns. Ferns are a group of plants that are all vascular and produce spores instead of seeds. Ferns undergo an alternation of generations in their life cycle, which consists of two generations, the gametophyte generation, which is haploid, and the sporophyte generation, which is diploid. The gametophyte generation starts with haploid spores being released from sporangium on the mature fern frond. These spores grow through the process of mitosis. A single spore continues to grow into what is known as the gametophyte, which is heart-shaped. This heart shape grows and becomes larger and more distinct and is easily seen with the naked eye. Mature gametophytes are hermaphroditic. They have both sex organs. The gametophytes have female sex organs called archegonium, which contain the female gametes, the eggs. They also have male sex organs called antheridium, which contain the male gametes, the sperm. In an individual gametophyte, the male and female sex organs mature at different times to reduce self-fertilization. The sporophyte generation starts with the fusion of a haploid egg and a haploid sperm. This process is called fertilization. This occurs within the archegonium on the gametophyte. The sperm is released from an antheridium and swims to the egg in the archegonium. Because the sperm swims to the eggs, the presence of water on the fern gametophyte is essential for fertilization to occur. Once fertilization occurs, the diploid zygote is formed within the archegonium. The zygote continues to grow through the process of mitosis, forming a diploid plant that is known as the sporophyte. As the sporophyte continues to grow, it will grow fronds. The sporophyte in ferns is actually the dominant generation and what we recognize and call a fern plant. Eventually, the sporophyte will mature and form small structures on the underneath of the fern fronds called sori. Sori are actually small clumps of sporangia. Inside the sporangia, haploid spores are created through the process of meiosis. These spores are then released and the cycle continues. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.